Hello, hello everybody, this is MineCralex here, and in today's video we're going to be playing Minecraft Diamond Superflat Survival, and this is episode 3 of my series where I survive in a Diamond Superflat Survival world. And I'd like to start off by thanking you guys so much for supporting my channel. I had never even dreamed of having so many views, so many subscribers. It's just crazy. Every single day I go on my YouTube channel, which is every day, I am just simply amazed by the amount of subscribers and by the amount of views I have. I really never even dreamed of having this much views and subscribers when I started this channel out, because even having 20 subscribers for me was completely huge, and now having more than 2,500 subscribers is just it's just unreal. And I've recently hit 1 million views overall on my channel, and of course I could have not done it. I couldn't have reached this number of views and subscribers without each and every one of you, so I personally thank each and every one of my viewers for supporting my channel so long. And this is actually a very influential video and influential series, because as many of you know who watched my first episode of this Let's Play series, that the video currently has more than, I think it's around 600 or 700,000 views, which is just simply crazy. I had never even dreamed of having 1,000 views in a video, nevertheless, even 700,000 views. So let's go ahead and take our diamond sword and go outside. It seems as if though some mobs are, some zombies, some villagers are getting eaten by the zombies around here. So what I think I'm gonna do, let's see. Oh, yes, so it looks like I have all my diamond tools with me right now, so oh, that's not good. So let's see, let's try to go ahead and kill the zombie right here. What I don't really understand is, oh yeah, there's some thunder outside. This might be bad, because we might have some charged creeper spawning. Oh, come on. Well, apparently, through the door, the zombie somehow consumed the villager and ate the villager, which then turned into a zombie villager. Anyway, another thing that I'd like to mention is that, yeah, we really gotta somehow fence this village off somehow, because there's just way too many mobs around here. And by the way, guys, if you noticed, oh, there's a little bug. Let's see, can the spider hit us through here? Looks as if, though, yeah, I think there's just a hitbox glitch where villagers are able to be, I think zombies are able to hit from about this far, so any villagers standing around here would be eaten and consumed by the zombies. So another thing that I'd like to say for the Let's Play is that all of my previous two episodes that I filmed, I have actually been in version 1.5.2. Well, I upgraded the version of Minecraft that I'm playing to 1.7.10. Okay, let's just go and massacre all these villagers. I mean, all these zombies, because we just can't have them stand around here. So let's see. Well, yeah, us and with our diamond armor, I think it's not going to be an issue killing all the zombies around here. Oh wow, he was carrying a little. Yeah, this is what I was hoping would not happen. Okay, there we go. Whoa, we got some sugar. That's pretty rare. So let's see. Let me just wait this out until the poison ends. Yeah, this is gonna take quite a while. The witches are the most annoying, because they're able to poison you, which makes you very vulnerable to any attacks, especially when you have half a heart. Pretty much any attack from any other mob or any other type of damage that deals as little as half a heart of damage will kill you at this stage, so I have to wait this out. So now I'm just gonna wait until I regen, and then I'm gonna go out real quick. And also another reason why, now some of you may be wondering why you cannot hear the sound of the rain pouring down, because usually rain is very loud in Minecraft. The reason for this is because I have turned down, okay, let's just eat some more carrots so we can regen. Actually, the reason why you can't hear any of the weather or any of the lightning, which usually creates quite a bit of noise in Minecraft, is because I have turned down the weather sound to a minimum, so I have both music and weather off, because the music and the weather can really get annoying once they really start pounding on you, especially some of the music. I mean, I like music in Minecraft, but if I'm making a let's play, I just prefer not to have that distraction there. And especially for the weather effects and for the rain, I prefer not to have the noise, because it's just this noise that just really, it's not fun to hear it, especially when there's let's see, are we on hard mode? Oh yeah, we're in hard mode, that's why they're, because on hard mode, zombies can actually knock down doors. So let's go ahead and try to, uh-oh, yeah, this is not good. So let's see. Oh, okay, there's a creeper there, so I think we're, okay, this is not good. There's way too many zombies out here. I hope this is not a zombie siege. Oh yeah, this is, I think that zombie siege is actually glitched out in 1.7.10, so that's why they actually don't exist. Oh, looks like, oh wow, there's an Enderman somewhere. Well, we won't have to worry about Enderman as it's raining, and then they're just gonna keep on despawning and respawning wherever they teleport. So let's see, are there any more zombies here? So let's just barricade all these houses inside with well, let's use dirt instead of that, just so. Okay, oh wow, chainmail armor, let's see if we can get some. Wow, fully covered in chainmail, it's pretty rare. Oh my god, we got chain leggings, that's pretty cool. So let's see, let me go ahead and barricade all this in there. And because what this is going to do is it's going to prevent zombies from getting in here. Actually, the weather effects and the rain is really kind of not really good for me, because as you can see, it's currently daytime, but we don't see any of the mobs despawning or any of the mobs disappearing, because, and the reason for that is because it's too dark for them to despawn. They're still spawning even when it's raining. So let's see, where are they trying to get into? Oh god. So let's try to, yeah, I have a feeling that in pretty soon we're not gonna have any alive villagers here at all. So let's see. Okay, maybe we might still be able to save them. Oh, nope. Okay, let's critical hit them. Oh, yeah, that villager's probably gonna die now, unfortunately. Yeah, if we are ever going to want to set up any type of, an iron golem farm, or any type of, farm which is going to need villagers, we're not gonna be able to do it in this village, because this village is going to become extinct pretty soon. Okay, this is not good. Let's go and try to kill that. Can we just use my diamond axe to knock this down? Okay, there we go. This is not gonna be an issue. So let's see if we go around. So let's see. I would really need to have a bow and arrow sometimes. So, well, I do have a bow, but I just, oh yeah, I do. I have some arrows. Yeah, so that's what I'm gonna use to kill any really hard to kill mob if I need to. Yeah, this is gonna just kill him. So there we go. So let's see, let's put the fence down right here. Let's see, I wonder if the creeper can explode from here. Yep. Oh well, there we go. Well, let's just go ahead and get some diamonds from there if we ever need some. Interesting, doesn't look like we have any diamonds. Actually, where is our base here? I think, so as far as I know, I don't really remember this let's play very well, because I don't remember this let's play very well, because the last time that I played this, it was, yeah, this is not good. Oh, looks like we have come from another village, that's why. Because I remember, the only thing I remember about this let's play is that I have a base completely made out of diamond blocks, and this village does not seem to have any type of base there. And I'm sure we have a house somewhere made out of diamond blocks, I just don't really remember where. But it seems that the reason we are in this village is because I decided to go and scout out for an additional village, which I found somewhere over here. And what I usually do is I just lay down blocks when I go to scout out for villages just to know my way back home. So apparently that village is just my temporary residence, not permanent. And actually, now that I'm much more experienced in Minecraft, I know how to play these types of Let's Plays much better in these types of worlds, because the last time that I actually played, when I started this Let's Play, it was around in, I actually started this Let's Play in the year 2015, so that's 2015, and as of now, right now, it's 2017. I don't know if any one of you are watching this in the future, somewhere in 2018 or even 2019. Well, hello to you people watching in the future. I wonder how my channel is going to be in the future. It's hopefully going to continue to grow as it has been growing recently, which has been just, like I said before, simply amazing. I just still can't grasp the idea of having this much views and this much subs. So, oh yeah, we're not going to be able to run soon, so let's just eat some carrots. Now, about not being as experienced in Minecraft two years ago, is because, actually, I think that looking back at my Let's Play from 2015, the last episode that I posted, episode 2, for the Diamond Superflat Survival, it was made somewhere around... Oh, I thought that was a spider jockey, but it's just, that's just, a skeleton standing very close to a spider, so let's see. Yeah, I'll just keep running, and wow, they just keep spawning and spawning. Oh yeah, I think that's the village where we have our house there, so... So anyway, let me resume my conversation that I have, not finished yet, so... Oh yeah, I think I use different markings. Oh wow, the armor's pretty good. As you can see, we're not even getting any damage from these creeper explosions when they're far away, because the armor is just taking up all of the damage. So let's see. Yeah, this is not good. I feel like this village is going to become extinct as well. So let's see. Let's just try to find a. Oh, there we go. So yeah, here's where my house is. It's made out of diamond blocks. Yep, this I remember. So let's see, looks like I have quite a bit of diamonds. Let's see, let's put down my wooden door. It kind of feels as if though I'm seeing this for the first time, because I'm not actually... Let's see, do we actually have any saplings? Oh yeah, we do have saplings. So, let's see, oh, that's why. So it seems as if though we need more obsidian blocks to finish this. So let's see. Okay, I think right... So right there, that's where my mine is. Oh yeah, that's where I sleep. Oh, I think the reason why... Now, I'm starting to remember... Let me just eat that carrot before I say anything else. So I'm actually starting to really remember what type of Let's Play I was doing. The reason I think that I have my bed here is because when I had my bed somewhere over here, I was not able to sleep in it because it said that there's monsters nearby, so I can't sleep, so that's why I took my bed and brought it down there. So let me just reclaim my bed. Let me just take it and just put it back where it really looks like it should be. So let's see. I'll just put it somewhere right here. Yep, that's a good place for a bed. So looks like we have... Oh, I think the reason... Yeah, that's the... That's the music record player. I think the reason we crafted that is just for fun, because we have so many diamonds out here, and obviously it takes diamonds to craft that. So let's see, maybe we could... Looks like we have a little farm going here, so let me just... Let's see. I just had thought that I heard a creeper or something, so... anyways. Let me just, take all these carrots out here. Okay, anyways, so, I actually am, a lot of people have been, oh yeah, let me just use that diamond hoe to plant some more, carrots down here. Now, I'd like to say, a lot of people in the comments section, hold on, I need to set up some type of tree farm around here in case I need to start tree farming. Actually, what would be much better if I had actually... Is there actually any stone around here? Do we have any stone? I don't, as far as I know, I don't think we have cobblestone down here. I don't remember the type of superflat world that I created, but it seems as if though the diamonds go really far down. So anyway, like I was saying, now I have actually been following my... I have not really been posting on YouTube recently. That reason is because I have not really had much time to post much videos on YouTube, so unfortunately I've been kind of neglecting my YouTube channel for a while. But, oh yeah, we have some stone over here, so let's see. So let me just go ahead and okay, this is not very efficient, so let me just break that and replace that with some cobblestone over here. Let's see how much. Oh yeah, we do have some cobblestone. Let's see, that's hopefully gonna replace that. Yep, there we go. Nice. So like I was saying, I have been somewhat neglecting my channel for quite some time now, although it may seem like I have not been active on my channel. I have been visiting my channel every day and as often as I am able to. I've simply not really been able to keep up with all of the work other than YouTube that I have going on and all the other stuff that I have to do. So additionally, I've actually been trying to learn how to do better video editing, so I've been learning how to, I've been watching tutorial videos online of other, YouTubers. Let's see, how should we position the torches here? So let's place a torch each two blocks. That seems like it would be good. Although, we could go for three, so let's just, one, two, three... torch, one, two, three, torch, and then right here, just for symmetry, right here, there we go. That seems like it'd be nice. So, like I was saying, I have actually been searching up some tutorials online on how to do video editing, so I'm going to start creating higher quality videos for my YouTube channel. I have been learning how to use this free and open source video editing software available for GNU Linux called Caden Live. Some people pronounce it Kinden Live or Caden Live, however you want to pronounce it. It's spelled K-D-E-N and Live. And I think it's a great piece of software that can be used for video editing, for just general purpose video editing. I would not say it's too professional, but it's probably the most powerful video editing software available for Linux, and as far as I know, it's also one of the best free and open source video editing. It's one of the best pieces of video editing software. It's probably one of the best programs for open source and free video editing out there. So that's pretty much what I'm gonna use. I have been thinking about possibly trying to purchase or pirate something like Sony Vegas, or to use a more professional video editing program for my channel. Although I've looked at both ways. I could potentially pirate Sony Vegas, or I could buy it. Now, if I do pirate it, there's a pretty large chance of me, it's almost certain that by pirating Sony Vegas, or any type of video editing software, or any type of games, you're gonna be letting in viruses or unwanted software onto your computer, which could potentially track you, or could potentially try to steal your identity. And I really don't like installing malware on my computer, so I just prefer to stay... I just prefer to buy my programs instead of cracking them, or at least have a computer which is specifically made for cracked programs, which I know has viruses on, which I just use for cracked programs. But that would just not be effective, because if you think about it, how am I going to access that computer for video editing? I'm just going to have to jump from one computer to the other to keep doing video editing. And even then, I really don't have enough money or a I don't have enough money to buy... to buy another license of Windows 10 or Windows 7. And a lot of people have been saying that you could purchase Windows 10 or Windows 7 for like $20 or some product keys or the licenses to the operating system for as little as $20, but I really don't think that is true, and I have been thinking about pirating Windows 10 or the system itself, but I don't think that's a great idea as well, because that's just, it's not really good to pirate operating systems that should run on your computer, because, and in general, I just prefer using not pirated software. And I know this could be counterintuitive to some of you who have watched my previous episodes of Minecraft, Diamond Superflat Survival, because clearly, like I said, actually, like I said in this Let's Play, in this episode of this Let's Play series, the previous version of Minecraft that I used was actually a cracked version. That was the version that I think it was this version from Skycraft, and it's this, it's called Unblocked Minecraft or something like that, and it's this .jar file that which you can run on your computer, and it just basically, it runs Minecraft, but the only version that you could run through it is, I think, 1.5.2, and that's the reason why this Let's Play actually started out in Minecraft version on, I was actually originally playing Minecraft 1.5.2, and that's the reason why I had actually to update my version. So as you can see right here, when pressing F3, you can clearly see that it's Minecraft on the top left hand side. It says Minecraft 1.7.10, and a lot of people would probably ask why I did not upgrade to 1.10 or the most recent version, or 1.12 or whatever it currently is, I think 1.11. Well, the reason is because I really don't like the new mechanics of Minecraft. I really don't like how the new combat system works. Oh, it looks like, so let's go ahead and just try to craft a chest or something. Let me just throw some of this stuff out just for oh yeah, it looks like we have some planks available. Let's just craft a double chest there and just let's just plop it down, yeah, somewhere over here. So we'll just plop down all of our cobblestone right here. And actually, the reason why I'm mining all this cobblestone is because I'm going to use this cobblestone to build a large base for myself. Because this cobblestone, I'm going to mostly use it for walls, because I'm going to create a very high wall around an enclosed area, which is going to be the area that I'm going to use for my base, where I'm probably going to build a mob grinder to gather mob supplies and gather more more needed resources. So anyway, what was I saying? Yes, so the reason why I did not update to Minecraft 1.11 or Minecraft 1.12 is because I really don't like the new Minecraft versions and the new Minecraft system of, I guess, the new Minecraft system of combat and how it works. And as much as of, and I mean, it does make Minecraft more challenging, which I do condone, but I just really like older versions of Minecraft, and I just prefer to stay on the versions that I always played. And additionally, I don't think it's very safe to update. What would happen is, potentially, if I had updated from 1.5.2 to If I had updated this Minecraft world from 1.5.2 to 1.11 or 1.12, it could actually cause the world to somehow glitch out, and this actually happened to people before. I remember seeing a YouTuber, he tried updating, he basically opened a world from, I think from Minecraft Alpha or Minecraft Beta, so like something like Minecraft Alpha 1.2.6, he opened that world up in Minecraft, I think 1.7 or something, and that's basically upgrading your world by like, I think it's like 10 or 15 versions up, and that's not very safe, because that could cause your world to have glitches, and it could improperly render the world, because if the world rendering engine that Minecraft uses in the updated versions is different from the way that it renders the worlds in its previous versions, then updating those previous versions to newer versions could potentially break those worlds by somehow glitching them out and by rendering them incorrectly. And what would that do? That could potentially make the world unstable. It could have glitches. I could potentially lose all of the items that I have in my chests. That has happened to me before. And additionally, it could actually wipe out some of, let me just plop this down and let's see. Oh yeah, we're gonna have to get more torches, so let's see, let's just, oh yeah, let me just craft a furnace here so I can make more torches. So let's just move the torch over here, and I'll just place a torch right over here as soon as I'm able to gain access to more coal. So, another type of glitch that updating your world to a newer version could bring is that, let's see, let me just craft some of this. So potentially updating your world could cause a lot of glitches. Like, I've actually seen a YouTuber get his world, it just somehow got like sliced open. So basically, parts of his world got rendered incorrectly. So he had these weird, I don't know. I think his half of his base got. So I think that the rendering engine somehow it generated the map over his base, so it somehow cut half of his base off, and then it just created these weird fractures in the map, which basically made the map unplayable, or it just made him lose hours and hours of progress, and I really didn't want that to happen to me, so I just decided, well, why not just upgrade to my favorite Minecraft version, 1.7.10. In my opinion, 1.7.10 is one of the best versions because it has 1.7.10 has some of the best mods out there. A lot of the mods were made for 1.7.10 because I think that's the last version of Minecraft which is not in 1.8, and when 1.8 got rolled out, a lot of different changes were made to Minecraft. The engine was changed, a lot of other attributes of Minecraft were changed, a lot of the type of way that Minecraft, I think a lot of different parameters got added to Minecraft because Minecraft began to have a local difficulty. It began counting more, it became more technical in terms of, it became, because in 1.8 you can go to a block, and when you look at a block, it tells you the state of the block in the F3 menu up in the left hand upper left hand side corner, which I, as you can see right now, it just told you the status of the block, it told you the light level of a block, and Minecraft was just completely overhauled in a way that I don't really like. And also in 1.8, I think powered rails and minecarts kind of got nerfed, so they don't work as well as they do in 1.7.10. And not to say that, oh, there we go, it's done. Not to say that Minecraft 1.7.10 doesn't have its glitches, which it certainly does. And as we have even seen in, as we have even seen recently, there are some glitches like hitbox glitches when the zombie was able to kill the villager through the door. There are definitely glitches in 1.7.10, but these glitches are not enough for me to say that I'm going to switch to 1.8, because 1.8 has as much, if not more, glitches than 1.7 does, and certainly the newer versions do have glitches as well, because some of the glitches, they don't, especially the newest versions, especially the snapshots, which are like, previews of future Minecraft versions, those usually have the most bugs, because those are the versions which are not tested extensively by players, and they're just the reason why Mojang releases them to, or, well, not Mojang, but Microsoft, now that Microsoft owns Minecraft, and the reason why Microsoft releases those snapshots out into the public is because they want players to play the snapshots and then report any types of bugs that they find with it so that they can patch the bugs. But a lot of the times some bugs are just too difficult to fix, or they just get somehow overlooked, or never really get updated. So that's really my reasoning behind why I did not update to a newer version of Minecraft. So anyway, I was thinking about the future of this Let's Play, and I think that I'm going to continue this Let's Play like I'm currently continuing my Minecraft Vanilla Superflat Survival Let's Play. I think this is going to be... Oh yeah, my Windows 10 is just notifying me that a new version of Java is available. Quite ironic, because I'm currently running Java by playing Minecraft, so... Well, I guess I'm going to be ending the Let's Play pretty soon, because it's really been... Oh, wow. It's just been nighttime, and now it's daytime again, so I think that this Let's Play has been long enough, but, of course, the first episode of this Let's Play series was way too long. It was, I think it was an hour or something, maybe even longer than an hour, but it was way too long, so I'm gonna try to keep my Let's Plays a bit more, more concise, more to the point, try to do more, I'm gonna try to do a little bit more work off camera, especially some of the more tedious work like mining stone, which is not really interesting. But the reason why I was mining stone on camera is because I wanted to explain some of the things that I did not really get to explain in a while. And oh, also about explaining things to you guys, I'd like to say, oh, I should probably just have the ladder come out here just so it'd be easier. So now, actually, I just remembered, the reason why we need more, why I need more iron ingots is because I need to take the iron and I want to craft a bucket, because I currently still do not have a bucket for, to take the lava. And when I saw this lava here, I was wondering, well, why is this lava here? Why don't I just take it and cast these two obsidian blocks over here? Because, and the reason for that is because I still don't have a bucket to take the bucket and pour water and lava over here and create a mold casting so I can fill in these two obsidian blocks. Or actually, I don't need to mold, I actually really don't need to mold any of, any blocks, because if I'm able to get water to flow under here, I can just use my diamond pickaxes to mine the obsidian and then take that obsidian and, just place it over here. I don't know, maybe we might be able to have... Actually, now I was thinking, maybe we might be able to have the water somehow pour on top of the lava and create, maybe we could have it create, let's see, maybe cobblestone, maybe obsidian, but we would have to have the water flow on top of the lava to have it create obsidian, which is difficult because the water is lower than the lava, so it only makes sense if the lava would flow on top of the water. So, yeah, that's that. So, anyway... Let me just organize some of this stuff around the chest. So, I'm like I said before, I'm going to end the episode pretty soon. Now, I'd like to say one thing that I really did not get to say. A lot, I've been reading up on some of the comments, and a lot of the people in the comments section for my most popular video for this Let's Play series, especially Episode 1 and Episode 2. Actually, Episode 1 and Episode 2 are the only episodes available, because this is... Episode 3, so I take my word back. So mostly in episode 1, that's the video which got like, let's see, I think 600,000 views. I've been reading up on the comments, and a lot of people have been saying how I'm, oh yeah, we have some more ladders we could go ahead and replace. Could build some ladders up here. So let's see, let's just build another ladder that goes up here just in case. Anyways, I've been reading up on some of the comments. A lot of people have been saying how I'm a noob in Minecraft and how my videos really suck. Well, I kind of thought this over, and I'd like to say that back in 2015, which was 2 years ago, that's when my channel was kind of starting out. I think I had around 100 subscribers or so. That's when I actually made the Let's Play, the Diamond Superflat Let's Play. And I'd like to say that back then, I was actually a noob in Minecraft. It's because I have not really played Minecraft for that long. I started playing Minecraft, let's see. Oh, wow, we got an achievement. Oh, come on, let's see. Let's just replace this with diamond blocks. So, anyway. So, like I said, a lot of people have been saying how I'm a noob and everything. How I was playing like a noob. So, I'd like to note that back then, in 2015, I was actually a noob in Minecraft. Because by that time, I had only had less than a year of playing Minecraft. I think only I had a few months of playing Minecraft. And, additionally, the video was not really well edited. And the reason for that is because that... was when I was really starting out as a YouTuber, and I really did not have the recording software, and I had, well, I used the free version of Bandicam with a watermark for one thing, and I read quite a bit of comments of people complaining about how I was using the free version of Bandicam with a watermark. Well, now that I have bought Bandicam, and now that I mostly use OBS to record, I don't have that watermark. Now that I have bought a new microphone, which is the Blue Snowball, which I'm currently using right now, the audio quality is much, much superior than, much, much better than it was before as well. So, any of the people who are saying how, you know, my channel sucks, how my videos are not really that good, I have to admit, my videos back in 2015 were not the best. They were kind of crappy, even by my standards. So, hopefully, I'm going to keep continuing. I'm going to try to keep continuing and keep improving my videos further, because I want my videos to be the best that they can be. And every single time that I make a video, I put my heart and soul in it to make sure that it's the best, simply the best video that I can make it. So that's that. And yeah, so the reason why I took some cobblestone is that I just needed some cobblestone to fill all of this stuff in. So let's see. I just want to collect this wood since we really need more wood. And I really want to start, I'm actually probably going to start a wood farm pretty soon, because it'd be nice to have. And by wood farm, I mean I'm going to have a small area around somewhere around here where I'm going to plant saplings and grow trees out of them. So there is still quite a bit of wood around here. I just don't really like taking all the wood from around here, because all this wood serves a purpose, and it kind of looks barren if it's like this. Or I might just probably replace it with cobblestone or something. But then that might not look as good as it would with wood logs over there. So anyway, so once again, I'd like to say, okay, let's see. Let's just I need to craft some more diamond blocks to do that. So anyway, like I said, my channel has gone so far thanks to all of you guys. I just need some more diamonds so I can make 8 diamond blocks. So like I said, my channel has gone so far, and I would have never gotten to get, I would have never gone this far without you guys. So I thank each and every one of my viewers. Thank you very much for supporting me through the years so far. I started my channel 2014, so let's see, it's been around 2-3 years since I've had my channel running. So through these 2 or 3 years that I've had my channel running, you guys have supported me enormously. I could have not done it without you guys. I thank each and every one of my viewers. It's been a great journey with you guys, and hopefully it's going to continue to be such a great journey, and hopefully my channel is going to continue to grow. I'm going to start to diversify my channel as I'm going to have more time. Maybe during the summertime I'm going to post even more videos, and hopefully my channel will keep growing at the same rate that it's growing right now. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. This is MineCralex. Like I said before, thank you very much. I thank you guys so much. And yeah, see you all guys in the next video. I hope you enjoyed.